Hello YouTube, my name is Isabella and welcome back to my channel, Stubbornly Bookish. Today I'm going to be quickly talking about the books I read in December. To be honest, not many of the books in December made an impression, or if they did, it was a terrible one, so I don't feel like spending too much time on these. Two of these books were one-star reads, so you'll see them in my least favorite, and I only really enjoyed, like, two of the other books I read, and I read six books total. So we're just gonna jump into it. These are going to be very brief, very quick, and let's just get into it. So the first book I completed in December was The Subtle Knife by Philip Pullman. I was inspired to read this book because of the TV show. I watched the first episode and people were tweeting saying that they kind of discuss stuff that comes up in the later books, so I wanted to finish those before continuing on with the show. I enjoyed this, but I didn't love it as much as I enjoyed The Golden Compass. This definitely feels like a bridge book. There was a lot of plot conveniences that were a little annoying. We're introduced to some new characters, which I liked. I really liked the character Will that we get introduced to. However, I think Lyric somewhat takes a back seat, and I would have liked her to have a more active role in this story. I like that it still pulled its punches. There are some emotional things that happen in here, and I'm just so impressed that this is a middle grade series. I still really enjoyed it. I'm very interested in reading the final book in the series, and yeah, it was okay. Not great. I think I gave it 3.5 out of 5 stars. The next book I read on audio, and that was The Afterlife of Holly Chase. This is a very popular young adult paranormal story that is inspired slash retelling of A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. That is a lot of words in one sentence. And the book is by Cynthia Hand. This story was a really fun and sort of modern take on A Christmas Carol, which I read, I guess, 2 years ago now, but I read in 2018 and didn't actually really enjoy it. It was really fast paced, easy to get through. Not a whole lot was going on. It was a very sort of small story, or focused on a small set of characters, and I did actually like Holly. Holly is our Scrooge, kind of not a great person. I wish there would have been a little bit more nuance with her character. I was very engaged. I was guessing the whole time how things were going to end. I don't think that this is the best book ever. It didn't quite hit that mark for me, but it was fun. The characters were interesting. Didn't like the romance though. That took up a large portion of this story, and I wasn't quite on board for the romance, but it was just fun, honestly. And if you're looking for a Christmas read in 2020, I do recommend that one. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. Pretty enjoyable. The next book I completed took me forever to complete, and I don't want to talk about it at all. One of my most anticipated releases of the year. I fully expected to give it 5 stars, and I gave it 1 star. And that is Good Ol' Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. I hated this book. I don't know if I need to post an actual review of this story to get out all my thoughts, but I know it will be just me rambling for like a half hour. But I don't think that this was a good story in any sense of the word. In terms of the construction of the narrative, it was deeply flawed. The way that things were paced out, the way that scenes were put together was unnecessarily confusing. We have a character in here that we only get his perspective from the past timeline, and he doesn't even fucking show up in the book. Ooh, yeah. I'm mad about this book. I keep forgetting how mad I get about this story. The characters were really flat. Their motivations didn't ever fully make sense. The writing in here was so overwritten, so overly descriptive, and also tries to like smack you over the head with the fact that this is an adult story and not young adult. I didn't find one thing redeeming about this book. I gave it 1 out of 5 stars. This will definitely be featured in my worst books of the year, and maybe I'll post that review. I don't know. I'm kind of scared. I am shocked. Truly shocked. The next book I also read was also a sequel, and that was Arch Enemies by Marissa Meyer. This is the sequel to Renegades, a kind of superhero, supervillain type story. It is the middle book, and boy does it feel like it. I know I might have said that The Subtle Knife felt like a bridge book. This middle book syndrome, bridge book, whatever you want to fucking call it, but this one also really, really does that. Nothing really happens in this book. where we start off to where we end, nothing huge happens. There's no huge moments of character growth. The plot of the story doesn't super change, other than one element that gets thrown in here that I think is just very stupid. This plot element is honestly just thrown in there so our main character, I think, seems more sympathetic and that the reader gets on her side because she's actually a villain or supposed to be a villain. There were things that I enjoyed about it, and I think when I first read it I gave it 3 stars, but I have lowered it to 2 stars. I don't think this book needed to exist. The Renegades trilogy was supposed to be a duology, and this book really, really shows that. And I am pissed that I spent money when I was in the US for this edition. So who knows if I'll finish off the finale. I'm not entirely sure just yet. I didn't realize how bitter I am about a lot of my December reads until now talking about them. So that's fun. But the one book I genuinely really enjoyed in December was Wild Beauty by Anna Marie McLemore. I've been wanting to read their books for such a long time, and this was a great place to start. From what I know, they write incredibly queer books, like, across the board. This one follows one girl in particular, but she's in a family of 5 cousins with their 5 mothers and their 5 grandmothers, because they are actually cursed to live in this, like, super lush garden that they can't leave. Every time they fall in love too deeply, the person they love actually disappears and they don't know what happens to them. Everything kind of changes when a boy actually comes back, and everything they thought they knew is kind of thrown up into the wind, and they just have to kind of deal with that. All 5 of the cousins are actually bisexual or somewhat on the queer spectrum, which I loved. And even though this features an MF romance, it is, like, still super queer. This book just oozes, I don't know, it was just so magical. This is a magical realism story, an Own Voices magical realism story, and it was just phenomenal. The writing was beautiful without, like, being annoying. The description of, like, the vivid gardens, the lushness, all of that was great. And then there's also some elements of some really hard-hitting things, such as colonialism, brought up into this story that I wasn't expecting, but I really, really appreciated it. I also super loved the emphasis of family and sisterhood, even though they are cousins. Cousinhood sounds dumb. But the tight-knitness of the cousins was so wonderful. The more I think about it, the more that this book stands out to me. I really, really enjoyed it. I really love this book. Gave it 4 out of 5 stars, like a high 4. It was great, and the one shining moment of December. The final book I read in December, my final read of 2019, was a hot mess. This will also be featured in my worst books of 2019. It's On the Other Side by Carrie Hope Fletcher. I don't think this is a particularly well-known book, but I've been meaning to read this forever. I've owned it since, like, early 2016, and it was just time to get this book read. And boy, was I mistaken. This book is essentially set after our main character dies and is going to heaven, but before she can ascend to heaven, she has to confront some things in her past and kind of reveal some of her, like, closely guarded secrets for her soul to be light enough to go to heaven. So not something typically that I would think I like, but in 2016 I was still really new to finding new things to read, and I really like Carrie Hope Fletcher. I love her YouTube channel. But this was a travesty. To start off, the kind of world building in here is crap. And you'd think, in a contemporary story, what do you mean the world building was crap? I mean, I don't know when this story took place. There was no mention of an era, of a setting, nothing. They're acting as if she's growing up in the 40s and her restricted mother is so terrified that she's gonna have, like, a spinster on her hands who's 27. But then I think there's also the mention of, like, cell phones and stuff. Like, nobody knows. And this is supposed to be, like, a star-crossed lovers fated to be but can't be, and it's so tragic, but really it's garbage. You know how you have a white savior throw a white person in to save, like, an indigenous group of people and everyone looks upon them with reverence? I don't know what the term is for the like queer version of that, but this is what this was. And not that it was particularly offensive, just it was just stupid. I gave it 1 out of 5 stars. If I could give it 0, I would. Ooh, I'm bitter. I was literally just preparing to take my thumbnail, and I forgot to mention that I actually DNF'd a book in December as well. I DNF'd the illustrated edition of Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone because J.K. Rowling sucks, and I was in the middle of reading it when all of her bullshit garbage tweets came out. It didn't seem right to be reading that book when she was being a monster, so I had to put it down. So my 2019 did not end well. Forgot about that. December was great. So that is it for all the books I read in December. What a train wreck. Truly, truly a train wreck. I don't even know what to ask. Let me know any book that surprised or disappointed you in 2019, end of the year, anticipated book, whatever, because boy, do I have some thoughts on certain things like that. But that's it for now. Hopefully this video wasn't too long. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I will see you again very soon. I have a lot of videos coming out. Bye!